This is a Tesla coil. It was invented some 90 years ago, but now a growing number of experts in the United States feel that it may form the basis of a new generation of Soviet weapons. They are known as radio frequency or RF weapons because they operate in the radio frequency spectrum. Their existence is noted in this U.S. Department of Defense publication, which says the Soviets could use them to destroy components of missiles, to interfere with radar and other electronic systems, and even to alter human mind functions. The concept of RF weaponry was predicted at the turn of the century by Nikola Tesla, an American who had emigrated from Yugoslavia. He is best remembered as the man who invented alternating current electricity. In 1899, Tesla built this giant coil, which produced 10 million volts of artificial lightning. From it, he theorized the possibility of death rays. This and many other of his ideas about the physics of electricity were ridiculed by the scientific establishment.
Pure science is not a sure thing. You can't predict what's going to work out and what's not going to work out.
Robert Gulka, a research scientist, built a replica of the Tesla coil about 80 years later. Gulka was trying to produce a phenomenon known as ball lightning. He also used a Tesla coil to conduct testing for the U.S. Air Force.
What I was doing was setting in maybe 5-foot-long models of advanced fighter aircraft, and we would want to try to find out which part of the airplane was more vulnerable to lightning strikes, whether it was a wingtip or the canard where the pilot sat.
These experiments could also demonstrate the effect of the electromagnetic pulse of a nuclear blast, and Gulka says the effect of RF weapons as well. Gulka thinks that Tesla's theory, that electromagnetic power could be transmitted through the Earth and its atmosphere without wires, is a key element in the Soviet Union's work on RF weapons. Tesla's novel weapons theories were generally ignored in the United States. Nikola Tesla died in 1943, and after the Second World War, all his papers and effects were shipped to his native Yugoslavia, where they were enshrined in a museum. Some say that that museum proved to be a gold mine for Soviet weapons scientists.
We haven't even formally, so far as I know, to ourselves admitted that these weapons exist in the hands of the Soviet Union.
Weapons analyst Tom Bearden, a retired U.S. Army lieutenant colonel, is among a small group of scientists and engineers who believe that the Soviets have perfected Tesla's ideas and are developing radio frequency weapons on a scale unimagined in this country.
There have been a series of tests of these kinds of weapons, apparently, for a number of years. For example, airliners from Iran, before the fall of the Shah, saw deep within the Soviet Union very large glowing spherical balls of light which started out small and then expanded to very large size, which are apparently these kinds of weapons for use in an anti-ballistic missile defense role.
Bearden believes that these satellite photographs are of mysterious non-nuclear explosions near an uninhabited island in the East Siberian Sea, and that they are discharges from an RF weapon that uses intersecting energy beams called scalars.
In doing so, you can create, for example, either an electromagnetic explosion at a distance, or you can create an electromagnetic implosion at a distance, the extraction of energy from a distant point. This would look like a cold explosion, so to speak. And I believe the thing on April the 9th, 1984, off the coast of Japan that involved several 747 jet airliners, I believe that incident was a test of a cold explosion weapons. At least it met all the characteristics.
Pilot Doug Happ was in one of the 5 airline crews that saw an incredibly large cloud rising from the moonlit overcast below.
It looked like a plate coming up through an overcast, but it just kept expanding. And as it got higher, it was apparent that you could see right through the middle of it, so it looked like a big smoke ring. At the time that we first noticed this cloud, we weren't sure what to do, and we took no evasive action because we didn't know which way to go. And I think eventually we either ran through it or it completely engulfed us.
App says when his flight reached Anchorage, Alaska, it was checked for radioactive contamination. None was found. Dr. James Frazier has done extensive research in electromagnetic effects for the U.S. Air Force.
It could be due to a strong electromagnetic beam, but we don't know that. They can also be caused by chance terminal gradients. We've had for several years studies of clear air turbulence, for instance, which have produced this kind of a disruption. The people who sighted those are experienced pilots and should have been familiar with that kind of event. and this apparently was something outside their experience.
There have been a number of times when Soviet technological surprise has upset the strategic balance. In 1948, the Soviets detonated an A-bomb years before it was thought possible. In 1957, the Soviets stunned the world by launching Sputnik 1, the world's first artificial satellite. And in 1976, the Soviets were discovered to have been embarked upon a program to build particle beam weapons, a discovery which led, 5 years later, to America's Star Wars program. In each case, the United States was able to regain the balance. But this time, with radio frequency weapons, some scientists feel that the Soviet lead may be permanent. In my next report, how radio frequency devices can be used as weapons against the human mind. Chuck DeCaro, CNN, on special assignment.